Hey, Ann.
Hey, Jeff, how are you?
Good. Can you see me okay?
Yeah, I can see you okay.
Yeah, your video is off. You got a little button down at the bottom with a little video camera. Just click that and your video pops up.
Okay.
Yep, there you go. All right, all right.
Hey, hi. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good.
Good, all right.
Thanks for taking my call. My husband and I love your videos.
Oh, cool.
Sometimes we watch you on a Saturday night instead of a Netflix.
Hey.
We're like, honey, make the popcorn. Let's watch Jeff Gellman instead of a movie.
All right. Okay. Hey, if that's what it works for your date night, so be it. So, all right. So we got 15 minutes.
So, listen, I have a blue tick coonhound, a rescue. I know you say not to use the word rescue.
That's all right.
We've had her 8 months. We have her in New York City.
Yep.
Hello, a purebred hound.
Yep.
She's a great dog. She's 48 pounds. We had her on a harness until we discovered you online in October.
Okay.
The harness was horrible. She pulled my back out, pulling me down the street.
Yeah.
You know, nice dog, but we couldn't control her.
Yeah.
Dog walkers couldn't control her either.
Yeah. Yeah.
So anyway, the prong has been great. It worked perfectly for a while, and she doesn't. She walks better for my husband than for me. She responds to male energy better.
Okay.
But the real problem I'm having with this dog, and I feel like I could cry about it, is she is planting down on the sidewalk. She has recently started to really object to the prong by trying to shake it off.
Yeah.
And plant down on the sidewalk. And then when I give her like a little quick tug to try to get her up, she whines and she twists her head. She won't even look at me.
Yep.
And, you know, she really plants down. And then I try to lift her up with my arms, her torso, just to get her standing so I could move her forward.
Yep.
And then she lets out an audible. And I'm in the city. I've got people staring and commenting. It's so hard,
it's,
you know.
It's embarrassing.
And I really have to take her back in because she plants in the middle of the lobby of the apartment building outside.
Yeah.
Occasionally it's noise phobia, like if she hears a bang or a jackhammer,
yep.
She won't want to walk. But sometimes there's no noises and the dog is just doesn't want to go in the direction I want to go in.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, I mean, I pull, but she really takes a lot of pressure.
I know.
without working with me.
Yeah.
And you know, then I've got people walking by and of course someone with a Doberman goes by and then she leaps up and is like,
right.
You know.
Right.
So getting her off the ground is a problem just to walk her,
okay.
To get her to go out to go to the bathroom.
All right.
Right now.
All right. Hold on, Lenny, you can pick up the food and the water just so nobody trips on it. Okay. All right. And so the dog's from down south?
Yeah, she's from West Virginia. She was found with no tags.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Okay. So, you're in New York City. So what happens is you get a lot of these dogs from down south. We're going to get through this, don't worry. But you get a lot of these dogs from down south with no environmental stimuli. So they're not environmentally sound because they don't know everything from a garbage truck to, you know, other dogs walking on leashes to taxi cabs to the surface that they have to walk on, like the surface they have to walk on, manhole covers, your subway systems, your sidewalks actually vibrate because you've got subways running underneath them. We don't feel it as much, but the dogs do. So you've got everything going against you right now. The cool thing is this, if you took off the leash, what would your dog do?
She's a runner, Jeff. I mean,
bingo.
We have a weekend place and we,
yep.
Have her on a 30-foot rope.
Yep.
She's got away twice and,
yep.
We panicked.
Yep.
You know, I mean, she's gonna have to be because of the breed, because she's,
yep.
A purebred hound.
Yep.
She sees a squirrel and,
yep.
Rabbit.
Boom. Yep. Well, you're a remote collar trainer. The point is, if you took the leash off, the dog would get up and move. So,
yes.
The dog is not incapable of moving. The dog is objecting to your information. So your dog is objecting to your information. So what's it look like in the house? So forget about the walk right now. We'll spend a couple minutes on what does it look like in the house. How strict are you? Is the dog free roaming? Are you've got protocols in place? Like what happens inside the house?
Well, we're doing tons of your stuff. We're doing place. She's got the leash on in the house. She's got a kennel. She hangs out in her kennel and chills out in there. We put her in kennel when we're trying to eat dinner so she's not sniffing around us. You know, we crate her when we're not home.
Good.
I crate her when I go to the grocery store. Massive amounts of structure, as,
good.
You would say.
Yes.
And we love that because it gives us pieces of mind and it lets us live our life.
Good. The one thing to switch.
She's super smart, Jeff.
I don't care if she's smart. She's a pain in the ass. So what I want you to do is this. Instead of the crate, put her in place during dinner. So I want her to start learning that. Okay, this is what you're going to do. Are you on the remote collar yet?
Yeah, we just ordered this off your website. We
okay.
Haven't used it yet.
Okay, So start doing, the first command you can do is place with that. I've got a great video on place. Now, there's a couple ways to motivate a dog, right? You can motivate the dog with reward, or you can motivate them with pressure. Let's say the dog was planted on the ground. We see this all the time, just to let you know. Planted on the ground. And you held out a high profile treat to get that dog to move 2 feet. Would it move?
It would in the apartment. It wouldn't on the street if there were noises or distractions.
Bingo. Because the reward doesn't work. The fear overrides the reward. Now, what you do is you would use a remote collar. Some people struggle with this. You might struggle with this.
We're ready. We are so ready. We paid for this thing. Good. We're watching your videos. Good. We're like, so what we want a good dog.
So what we do is this. We use motivation. So what do we, you can only motivate a dog technically two ways. With yes, so with pleasure, or with discomfort. I mean, it's just the way it works. So you're gonna have to motivate the dog with a remote collar. So what you're gonna do is, what I want you to do with the leash first is this, before you even use the remote collar, is try to find an area that's not so crowded, which is hard because you're coming out of an apartment building, is instead of going forward, I want you to also go back towards your elevator. Is an elevator building?
Yep.
Okay, so say you didn't go forward towards the door, but you all of a sudden switched and you went towards the elevator. Would the dog get up and walk?
No, she would still twist her head. Well, she thought she was going back up to the apartment. Yes, she would. Because she'd be like, I'm not going out right now.
Bingo. We know it's not the tool. So we know it's not. That's what I want people to, because this is being videotaped. So they see me, they don't see you. I want people to understand the tool is not keeping the dog frozen. The fear is keeping the dog frozen. So we know, same leash, same collar, different direction, the dog walks fine. You want to go outside to where everything bad happens. So what you're going to do with this is you're going to use the remote collar. I want you to get a little bit used to it. Do it with place. What you're going to do is you're going to do the remote collar, and the dog's going to plant itself, and you're going to start doing something called dialing up. And remote collar on continuous, slowly dial up, slowly dial up, slowly dial up, slowly dial up, while you're doing leash pressure. Okay? So it's pressure, 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 leash pressure, leash pressure. You will get to a tipping point where that dog says, stay planted on the ground, or this is getting uncomfortable. How do I shut this off? I start moving. Boom, you immediately let go of the remote, like the stem.
Okay.
Now the dog, so now the dog goes, so if I move, stim goes off. Those are the rules. So yes, you are using discomfort to motivate your dog. Not abuse, not pain, but it absolutely will use discomfort. Now what'll happen is every time that dog plants, you just go, all right, fine. You're not yelling, you're not screaming, you're not doing anything. You're just going like this. Now, what you're doing is you're letting the dog know. We do this with fearful dogs all the time. You're afraid. I get it. The safest place for you to be when you are afraid is next to me in my direction at my speed. Mm-hmm. I'm moving forward, you move forward. I turn right, you turn right. I stop, you stop. If you're afraid of that noise, I get it. I'm not gonna say, you can't say to a dog, it's a garbage truck. They go, it's the scariest thing in the world. They don't know garbage truck. They don't know recycle bin. They don't know planter. They don't know newspaper. They don't know that stuff. What they know is, I'm afraid of that. So what do? Be next to me. Be next to me. Be next to me. So then what the dog goes is, if I stay next to Ann, life gets better. Yes, it does. Where Ann goes, I go. Correct. If I'm afraid, but I'm next to Ann, I get over my fears. Yes, you do. So how do you do that? And again, when that dog is next to you, a lot of times people try to reward the dog with food. The dog is still too afraid. So what do? You can mark it with a word, a verbal marker, good. And if you want to do good, a little bit of a head praise. Again, the dog isn't hearing or feeling the praise. Because they're still in what? You've been talking to me this whole time? Really? I didn't know that. Because I've been like, it's just like human. Everyone wants to humanize the dogs. We can humanize this to be like I'm afraid of roller coasters. I'm not, but I'm afraid of roller coasters. And I'm like shrieking the whole time. You literally have been talking to me the whole time. And I'm like, you were talking to me? I didn't even hear you. Why? Because I'm so afraid of roller coasters and I'm so occupied in my own mind. So that's how you're going to do that. Now that's what we do all okay. the, we do that all the time. Whenever you see a dog, like a video, yes, whenever you see a dog planting and then walking great, and everyone's like, oh my gosh, that dog looks so happy and it's so connected to the trainer. And I'm like, did you see that first video? Do you know how we got that? I assure you, we didn't get it by having a better bond or getting a better connection or rewarding it with high value treats. Why? None of that stuff will work.
Okay.
It won't work.
You know what I've been watching of yours again and again and again, believe it or not, is the feral dog video.
Yes.
Because she's not doing crocodile rolls or biting the leash, but yes. she did growl at me the other yes. night with the prong on, and I yes. thought, this is the closest video
yes.
you have
yes.
that's resembling my situation,
right.
and I've watched it like 20 times to see how you do pressure, you know what I mean?
Excellent.
And try to get the dog up and all that.
And you
stuff.
Saw, so the feral dog video was five dogs in South Carolina that were found out in the wild, deathly afraid of humans. You go to try to touch them, they pee and they poo. They were then put into a 4x8 run cement for 4 months. They never came out. At the sight of a human being, they ran into their kennels. Nobody can get them out in 4 months. I had 2 days to work with them. Day one,
wow.
they went for a 3-mile walk.
Wow, that's how amazing.
How do you think I did that?
Well, with a prong and
lots of pressure. What do
yeah.
you think they were trying for 4 months?
Yeah.
Coaxing, bribing, high-value food. The dog didn't care. This concept of if you build... Well, trust me, I want to build a great bond with my dog. But when my dog is scared shit in a corner, afraid of its shadow, it if anything, I'm making it worse. What you've got to do is you've got to make it uncomfortable to be afraid.
Yeah, and I don't know if I should tell, well, I should tell you, she doesn't do this, she gets walked with a group of dogs, she doesn't do this for the dog walker, and she doesn't pull this nonsense with my husband. So somehow she and I have a dynamic, and I think I'm tough, but my husband thinks I talk to her in baby voices too much and blah, blah,
well,
blah.
Do you?
So now I'm going to stop talking and use the remote. I just need her to behave better on the street.
Yes.
Because guess what, Jeff, there's a lot of pit bulls in this neighborhood.
I know.
There's a lot of Dobermans, there's a Rottweiler. And she's reactive right now, I think because of fear. And I could get into a situation
yes.
that got her close to me. But, you know, I got to get her under control. It's New York
yes.
City, you know. You can get into a lawsuit with a bite.
I know. I've got a lot of, half of our business is New York City. So, and I used to work dogs in New York City, in Brooklyn. So I'm really familiar. So this is the thing. I want you to have this. Do you have children?
I have stepkids, and she started rushing the door and being reactive to
okay.
them lately.
So what
lately.
I want you to do is, there's some things with kids, I wanted to just throw the kid connection at you. It's like, I really don't care if you like this or not. You have to do it. It's non-negotiable. So what I want you to do with your dog is, it's instead of like, come on, you can do this,
yeah.
it's more like, it's let's go. It's literally that attitude. We are going. So if you have to try that at maybe 2 a.m. when there's not as many people, you know, at the beginning, you've got to do it with low level distractions. You've got to do low
okay.
level distractions because, you know, personally, I don't mind the embarrassment, but I get that it can be embarrassing. So what do? Do it when there's not as many people around. Once you get that dog to start believing you, it goes away.
Okay, yeah, I'd say the toughest part about that, I don't mind the embarrassment, I'm a confident person and I've been watching your stuff, the audibles dog, because she's letting out a lot of audibles even on the prong.
Like,
and she's a hound, so it's really dramatic, like she's being tortured.
I know.
And I feel like someone from the ASPCA is going to like cuff me and take me away.
They might.
You know?
So this is the thing, you'll get through it, we've seen this, so the advice that I just gave you, I've probably done it 500 times with 100% success rate. So it works. But guess what? This is the messy part. So this is the messy part that like we show on videos, no one else does because it looks like you're abusing your dog. But you're not abusing your dog. Your dog is, this is all self-induced stuff. This is the kid. This is the kid in the candy store that has a hissy fit. You carry it out to the car, and everybody thinks you're creating all that nonsense. It's like the kid threw himself on the floor. I'd had nothing to do with it. All I did was say no. So you're saying to the dog, no, you can't lie down.
Yep. I can't tell sometimes if it's fear or just stubbornness, because occasionally there are no weird noises and the dog just doesn't want to go with me and she plants.
How about this?
So it doesn't matter what it is, right? It's like I just have to fix it.
Call it assholery, okay? Call it assholery, and that's what it is. And literally, your dog's just, and I love these animals, but it's being they're being a pain in the ass. I mean,
do you find it more with highly intelligent breeds that they know how to maneuver and manipulate? And
I find it with soft owners.
Oh no! Oh, Jeff.
And sorry.
Oh man. I knew that was coming. I emotionally prepared myself for that.
This
moment.
Isn't it.
But look, Jeff, I got the Herm Springer 2.25 with a carabiner from
good.
Eastern Mountains.
Good. Like, so this is the thing. And that's not a shaming, blaming comment, and it's just like trust me. I use my heart all day long. I mean, I cry at freaking Yellow Page. Well, they don't have Yellow Page at Hallmark ads. You know what I mean? I'm a really sensitive guy. I really, truly am. I mean, I got 6 daughters. I got a son. So this is the thing. But when it comes to dogs, I have to use my head before my heart. I have to. Or we won't have success. We won't.
Yeah. I mean, somehow I might not be taking it as far as I need to go, because she's learned she can game me and plant, and then we go back to the apartment.
Yep.
And the dog gets to go to the bathroom, but then the dog walker shows up with all the dogs and she prances off, and I'm like, what the F?
I know. You know what I mean? I know. Like, don't take it personally. So what I want you to do is you work on this, use the remote. I don't care how hard you pull on that leash, the dog ain't moving.
Yeah, thank you. Because I was like, this is the prong, and I kept thinking maybe one link less, but then it was getting so tight.
It's not a prong thing. It's not a tool thing. It's an asshole. Okay. It's an assholery thing.
Assholery. I cannot wait to tell my husband.
All right.
That is a new word in our life. Thank you
so
much.
All right, Ann. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Jeff. Bye.